Hey everyone, those of you who watch my debunks are likely aware that I consistently highlight the anti-establishment narrative as the hallmark of science denial. Anti-science propaganda almost always seeks to devalue the scientific community and academia in general, so as to prop up unqualified lying frauds or push a narrative that runs contrary to established facts. Want people to believe your lies over the consensus of the entire global scientific community? Weaponize the word consensus and train people to associate it with corruption. Want people to stay ignorant by avoiding education so that they're easier to manipulate? Tell them that universities are woke Marxist indoctrination camps that push an evil agenda. Want people to blatantly disregard the expertise of every single person who has dedicated their lives to a particular field of study? Tell them that all the scientists are corrupt liars, shilling for big whatever, so that they'll be receptive to the lies being pushed by some charlatan on the internet. It's a classic tactic. As you know, most of my debunks seek to combat disinformation. I expose charlatans and explain precisely how they are lying. But another approach to solving this problem involves demystifying science for the public. In addition to neutralizing lies, we have to rehabilitate public perception of the scientific community. You see, most people don't know a single scientist. They have no idea what scientists do. This makes them more likely to fall for these anti-science narratives because they have no real-life examples to compare with. But what if scientists could show people exactly who they are, what they do, and why? This was precisely my thinking in starting my Get to Know a Scientist series. This began years ago with one piece I produced on a UCLA geophysicist, but then I pivoted to having researchers submit pieces they produced themselves, and I received 8 such submissions ending a few years ago. These are great pieces that were sent to me by an entomologist, a geneticist, a marine ecologist, a plant biologist, a biochemist, a bioengineer, a herpetologist, and a neuroscientist. Here is a quick montage of some of the footage from their videos. As you can see, it's not super fancy. It's just them speaking into a webcam or even their iPhone, explaining what they do day to day, along with some footage of them in action, doing their thing. They are telling their story, explaining how they became passionate about their field, what they are researching at the moment, why it's important to them, any potential relevance for the public, and a bit about their future goals. The only reason I stopped putting these out is because I stopped getting submissions, but it's time to revive this playlist. Never has it been more important than now to show the public precisely who scientists are and what they do, because the impression they are receiving from the media and from the White House is grossly inaccurate. People have to understand that scientists are not greedy shills pushing an establishment agenda, or shifty charlatans lying for grant money, but rather passionate, underpaid professionals expanding the collective knowledge of the human species. If the public can become more aware of this reality, they will be less likely to fall for ridiculous anti-establishment narratives. So everyone out there, if you are a scientist of any kind and you're interested in being featured on my channel, you know what to do. Whether you're tenured faculty or a first-year graduate student, if you do any research in the lab or in the field, the world needs to hear from you. Show us what equipment you use. Show us what you do every day. Tell us why it matters to you and why it should matter to us too. Shoot me an email at professordaveexplains@gmail.com to talk to me about submitting a profile. Go science!